Joseph, you can't go to sleep feeling like this. I'm sorry for everything, and I know you need space, but I'm here for you. You don't need to feel so lost. Joseph, have I ever told you what my mother was like? You know what it's like not to have a mom at home. And you know how hard that made my childhood. What helped me was watching the birds in the morning before the school bus came. I thought that my mother was one of those birds. And it made me want to be free like her. My mom taught me how to fold origami cranes while she was in the hospital. So I told myself I would fold one every day until I could fly myself. I think we both have always loved animals, and for me that love started with a dog. Sometimes this Rottweiler would come up to our property line and wait at the fence for me, but only once in a while. I was sure to check every day immediately after school, and it usually ended in disappointment. I would even steal money from my passed out dad just so I could buy these off-brand dog biscuits. Even when she did stop by, she never went beyond the fence. Why was she so scared? I think my dad was the opposite of your dad in almost every way, except he was in the military as well. He coped with alcohol of every kind. The trailer started falling apart, he got angry, and I withdrew. More and more, I became the weird, quiet kid who made lots of origami birds and carried dog biscuits around. I think we were pretty similar when it came to being the weird kids. And that same sincerity in college was one of the reasons I was so drawn to you. Life got worse and worse. And at one point, I really didn't think I could survive another day with my soul still intact. I had no real friends, let alone neighbors, since we lived in the middle of nowhere. I should have talked to my teacher, but I was scared what he would do if he found out. As I waited for the school bus one morning, I walked around until I found something in an abandoned shed. Something I can't put into words. I summoned courage I didn't know I had, and I broke into my dad's room and found the key to the shed where he had locked my bike. I'll never forget that feeling. The wind rushing by my ears as the sun rose over fields of wheat. I was flying for the first time. I biked as far as my legs could take me until I found a house that felt friendly, and that felt like home. Those strangers helped me in so many ways. And if it wasn't for them, I wouldn't have found my foster family. And if it wasn't for my parents, I wouldn't have met you. You have strength, Joseph, and you're not as alone as you think.
It's all just so pointless. Just waiting for life to happen. It's like having the home I always wanted is cursed out of my reach. The thought of being a parent myself, how could I do that when I couldn't even be a good son? I'm sorry, I know what you're saying. I just don't know how things will work out. These quiet hours will turn into years. We'll wonder which roads passed us by.
Then we'll forge a new road together. Besides, I discovered for myself that one fateful morning where any hopeful road leads to. There may be thorns and mist, but it always leads to the same thing.
And what's that?
Family.
I'm so glad that you're part of my family, Rachel.
And I'm glad you're part of mine.
Thank you.
The fox knew her last cub would be waiting for her at the first tree. She was almost there. The rain cascaded onto the jade valley where the entrance to the tree was. Life was protected there, because that's where life began. It was now only a mother and a daughter left. Items from my life still dotted the ground as she moved closer to her destination and destiny. At the end of high school, I felt something I hadn't felt in a long time. Drive. I looked into the best architecture schools on the West Coast and got a dose of reality when looking at other students' portfolios and the high cost of tuition. I still wanted to be something, to be the next Alvaro Siza, and to make those thousands of sketches worth something in my grand history. But now even an internship sounds impossible. Siza helped me understand how essential emotion is in architecture. And he also said, light is the real composer of space. I like to think these glints of light, like not finding a job, or even a strange dream about a fox, are something I should be thankful for. Even if the illuminated space is something I'm less than comfortable with. My dad was super supportive with my college plans, to a point. Things were okay until this terrible accident happened. I guess a forklift flipped over due to a bad axle, and it crushed one of the workers there. My dad didn't eat for days. Even though he wasn't directly involved, it devastated him. Not only did it hurt the business, but it just freaked him out. He would talk in his sleep, muttering things about firing people and saying sorry. One fateful day, he approached me, said that since my school search wasn't going well, I should finally be a man and take over the family business. He said one day he was going to die, and that all of his work, sacrifice, and even that man's life would be wasted in vain. I just lost it. Teenage me just exploded at the thought. I screwed up. I said things I shouldn't have. He was having a crisis, and I pretty much spit in his face.
Was that the last time you talked to him?
No, I called on holidays, and he would call on my birthday. I guess we acted like nothing ever happened, which was stupid. Didn't want to ask about his lumberyard, and I'm sure he didn't want to ask about my job search. I never went back and visited. I think the last conversation we had was about what movies we had seen and what exactly a best boy is in the credits. I thought he would be here so much longer. In the distance, the first tree illuminated the wasteland. She couldn't go home anymore.